You'll be on the one side, and we've got plenty of space on the other side. All right, hand pose.
Oh, yes.
When I was younger, I was a top sportsman in everything I did. Athletics, swimming, and rugby. And I got provincial colours for all of them. And then when I was about 17, my dad told me that I needed to choose a direction and focus only on that one direction so I could make a career out of it. I prayed, and what God then did was he tore my hamstring. I couldn't swim, I couldn't do sprinting, and obviously I couldn't play rugby anymore. So because I had to spend a lot of time in the gym to strengthen the hamstring, that got me into the direction of bodybuilding, and one thing led to another, and here I am.
From a very young age, Mario's been very, very sport active. He always wanted to win, and he never disappointed. If you see the medals he's got and the diplomas he's got, the certificates he's got, Victor Laudoriums he's won at school, it's just been a pleasure. We're very, very, very proud of him, yes.
I also did sport when I was at school, and of course Freddie as well, you know. I've never been as good as what my boys are, that's for sure.
These over here, let's see, the one is the Leamington Spa and the other one is the London Championships. The 2007 Mr. Universe Championships that I won. All of these are all SA Championship trophies, different federations. This was the overalls at the NABBA one year. These are all national level trophies. This one over here is the World Championships one. I got that in Greece. Mr. Universe over there. These are also national and South African championships. This is also a national level trophy. This is the overalls. This is the 2009 super heavyweight first place. Those are my first trophies that I won, the small ones in the bottom there. I think this is my brother's. So he's also doing the bodybuilding now, and he's becoming one of the top amateurs in South Africa.
And that's my third year now. So highly motivated through my brother doing this, obviously.
I don't see myself as this overly muscular person that everyone sees. I see myself as a normal person walking around. I do bump into things every now and then. You are a little bit bigger than usual, but to me, you know, I don't feel any different. I still feel the same.
たとえ普通の人と変わらないとはいえ、この肉体を維持するのは大変です。オフシーズンは筋肉をつけて体重を増やすことに集中しますが、大会が近づくと生活は一変します。脂肪を落として筋肉を際立たせるため、トレーニングや食事を変更するのです。
You know, off season I use a lot of supplements. I use a lot of weight gainers. I use a lot of whey protein and creatine and stuff like that. But yeah, closer to the show, because your condition is so important and you want to be as lean as possible, we actually stay away from supplements. It goes purely food, so six whole meals during the day. I wake up in the morning and then I'll have my fat burners and then I'll go to gym straight away. From gym, I'll do an hour cardio. That hour cardio basically is when I lose the most fat during the day. And then straight from cardio, I come back and I have my first meal, my breakfast, which is oats and 12 egg whites. Second meal is where we are now. We'll have a 12 egg white omelet with sweet potato. Wait a while for the food to digest, then I go back to the gym. I'll have my proper workout. Straight afterwards, I have my next meal, two cans of tuna and another sweet potato. Then after that, it's every 2 or 3 hours I have another meal until I go to bed. The reason why I take the yolks out is obviously because of the fat content in the yolk. We try and keep food this close to the show as lean as possible. And during the off season, I prefer to have a steak meal before I train. Steak and rice, white rice. The reason for that being is you just feel so much stronger. You know? Being a pro athlete and being able to rest most of the day, gives me time to recuperate, and I don't really need an energy drink. I get my energy from my nutrition.
1日6回の食事で蓄えられたエネルギーはジムで燃焼されます。マリウスの食事は過酷なトレーニングに見合ったものなのです。
All right, we're working on our chest today. We work on sets and reps, as many as he can handle for the day. When he's had enough, he's had enough. Well, when he was a young man at 18 or 19, my wife and I got a phone call from this young guy, and we had just been to a show on that weekend, and Marius had actually posed on him, and he stole the show. He loves the stage, this man does. And anyway, he phoned us up and he said that he'd like to meet with us, and he's heard that I could help him and guide him on the right track. Please, could we meet somewhere and discuss and do what I can and help him with some kind of basic work? And that was, must be 12, 13 years ago now, yeah. He's like one of our family. You know, he's he calls me second father. And we're just so close, like father and son would be, yes, yeah. Yeah.
I basically go until I fail. With bodybuilding, you can, there's a thing called failure where you basically train the muscle to the maximum that you could train it.
A repetition range would normally start with 12 repetitions, and as the weight kept increasing, it would drop down to about 6 repetitions.
We've structured this training principles around my muscle structure. So, like, I've got a very overpowering shoulders to a weaker chest. So we've actually modified my shoulder workouts, and we've modified my chest workouts, try and bring my chest up and keep my shoulders the same, you know?
And then from then on, we'd move to another exercise.
At the end of the day, you're working the muscle, and it's not an ego thing where you're trying to lift up a big, humongous weight, you know, trying to impress girls or the other guys in the gym. It's all about contraction and the muscle. It's all about working the muscle, and it's all about smart training. So what we do then, after each set, we try and up the weight, and we try and match the previous set's reps, which will never happen because you get more and more tired, and that's how we train.
Maris は2011年フロリダ州タンパで行われた大会で優勝。プロとして挑んだ2度目の大会で快挙を成し遂げます。その結果、彼はミスターオリンピアの出場権を得ることができたのです。
I gauge that as my best condition ever. I've surpassed that. So I'm going into the Olympia pretty much in my best condition of my whole life. So I've done my work.
ついにマリウスがラスベガスへと向かいます。
He really deserved to be there. We know he's going to do well as well.
Oh, he's going to win. Definitely.
I'll put him in the top 10. Yeah, with confidence.
Once you win a show like this, the opportunities are unbelievable.
この後はマリウスがラスベガスでミスターオリンピアに挑みます。
Well, this is a pure liquid egg white, so you really get an all-in-one muscle-constructing protein.
Because this is the best of the best.
2011年のミスターオリンピアに南アフリカから唯一出場するマリウス。彼はボディービル界のオリンピックとも言われるこの大会で優勝するため13年間特訓を積んできました。
25 hour flight takes a lot out of you, and especially with the way that I fly, I'm not allowed to sit down for a long period of time. But yeah, I'm here, finally. I'm just gonna rest up, carb up, get the glycogen back in my muscle, and then it's time to rock and roll, baby. Vegas is absolutely crazy. I've never seen such an interesting place in my life before. Buildings, just the whole strip, it's unbelievable. I've been to quite a few places in the world, and Vegas to me is the most intriguing of all the places I've ever visited.
Joe Weider began the Mr. Olympia competition. Joe Weider essentially is the father of modern bodybuilding. Joe and Ben, started the IFBB. And that was in 1965, the first Mr. Olympia was held. Larry Scott was the first winner. And since then, it has been essentially the Super Bowl of bodybuilding, is the ultimate title to hold. Mass monsters is a term that describes just the big, the freaky guys. Arnold Schwarzenegger was a big guy. In order to win the Mr. Olympia title, you have to be impressive in size. Small guys don't usually win the Olympia title. So Arnold, Lee Haney, both of those guys were big bodybuilders when you compared them to the rest of the lineup. We have the Expo, which is 2 days, Friday and Saturday, at the Las Vegas Convention Center, which will be packed with people. I think something, you know, 30, 40, 50,000 people will walk through there over the course of the 2 days. We have some events, you know, Fitness the Figure, the men's 202 competition is held there. We also have some strongman competitions. There's grappling. Bodybuilding is still the core of Joe Weider's Mr. Olympia Weekend. It will always be the soul of Olympia Weekend, but it's evolved more to be a general health and fitness weekend in a lot of ways.
You got an expo, you know, in the Las Vegas Convention Center. It's got some t-shirts and things like that, you know, some souvenirs.
Well, this is a 100% pure liquid egg white. Effectively, I'm drinking an 8-ounce steak or a 10-egg omelet in a cup of cold coffee.
So you're really getting an all-in-one muscle-constructing protein.
Because this is the best of the best. An IFB pro bodybuilder at the Olympia, it doesn't get any better than that.
ボディービルダーとしての生活が健康を脅かす場合もあります。
It's all about, you know, just sitting there and just taking it up and appreciating life and being thankful for what you have and being thankful for getting a second chance.